Welcome back. This is the third and final video about the Articles and Databases tab, and it's going to focus on the databases available through EBSCO. So let's move to the correct tab and get going. As you can see, EBSCO is front and center, and we can get started in this widget right here with a multidisciplinary search of academic search complete. That means the widget is designed to search a pool of data that has a little bit of everything. It's great for the kind of broad searches you'll do when you're just getting started, using terms like resource conservation or electoral college. But once you work your way into a more focused topic, you might benefit from creating a custom search set, which you can do by clicking here. And this is the EBSCO database selection screen. ProQuest presented ready-made clusters of databases to you, but you do the work yourself in EBSCO. If we scroll a little bit, you can see from the individual database titles that EBSCO does a fantastic job with science, technology, and especially healthcare. The humanities are represented too, but science is probably a bit of a stronger show here. Now, for our purposes, we're just going to use Academic Search Complete today. When you create a set that you like, you'll hit Continue to visit the search screen. Now, honestly, this is not the most welcoming search screen. I usually just tell people to ignore everything from this gray line down. And that's because all of these filters are still easily accessible even after our initial search. So we can focus on just the search boxes. You can use one box in the search button for Google-style keyword searching, or you can play with different fields, additional search terms, and potentially Boolean operators. For the sake of a quick and decent search set, we are actually going to do a nice broad current event, and we're going to search for the Rio Olympics. And here is our search results screen. You'll notice it looks an awful lot like ProQuest. Our results are in the middle with our search terms in bold. We've got titles and we've got publication info, subjects. We've even got previews hiding under this little magnifying glass. All this is to say that we can learn an awful lot about an article before we even click into the full text. Over here on the left, there's also a healthy toolbar full of filters. The best advice I can give, make sure full text is clicked. From there, you'll notice that a lot of these are identical to ProQuest filters, and some are tweaked just a little bit, like geography for location. So go ahead and mix and match from these filters to customize your results and whittle away the junk articles that are slowing you down. For example, we might choose to click here and say, I only want articles about Rio. We've gone from 643 to 42 articles with one click. If you try something like this and don't like your result, click the blue X to go back a step. The worst you can do is start your search over. You're not going to break anything in here. So go ahead and try something different. All right, so when you find a source that you like, you may see HTML results, you may see PDF results, you may see both. Just remember what's best for your purposes. PDFs are good if you're interested in strong visuals and you know that your article has lots of charts and graphs or maybe photos that you'll need to see clearly, like this Summer Olympics preview from Esquire magazine. Whether you choose HTML or PDF, you're always going to be able to print it, to email it to yourself. You can create a folder and save it for later. You'll need a login and password for that. And you also have the option for some sample citations. So once you're done with a source, head back to your result list and keep searching. Once you take a little time to practice database searching and using these provided filters, you'll be so efficient, you'll leave open web searching like Google in the dust. Happy searching!